Hey y'all, Peter Combofeed Rose is here to discuss Evil Ryu in Ultra Street Fighter 4. Evil Ryu is known for big burst damage, but outside of that, his tools were a tad limited. Let's look at his changes to see if this issue was finally addressed. Evil Ryu players told us that Evil Ryu has decent damage output, but his low life resulted in them losing way before they could get their offense started. To address that, we've increased his total life by 50, which should definitely help in the long run. Evil Ryu's target combo was decent, however due to it only coming out after his close standing middle punch, its utility was rather limited. To increase its overall utility, the target combo can now be performed from further out, allowing for new pressure strings and combo opportunities. The primary purpose of Evil Ryu's forward and middle kick was to go over low attacks and allow him a way to get in from further out. Unfortunately, some characters duck too low to get hit by it, resulting in this move being less effective than it should have been. To ensure that this attack worked as intended, the hitbox around Evil Ryu's foot has been increased quite dramatically. Evil Ryu's Shoryuken attack into focus dash cancel forward was a great low-risk, high-reward method players would use to swing a match back into their favor without really worrying about possible repercussions. This has since been changed in Ultra Street Fighter 4 with a reduction on the advantage Evil Ryu receives after focus canceling an uppercut. If done incorrectly, Evil Ryu now faces the potential to be punished after a forward dash, so be more cautious when using this. Evil Ryu was a fairly good character in AE 2012 and only needed a few tweaks to become that much more solid. With the improvements to his vitality and key normals, Evil Ryu will definitely become a force to be reckoned with this time around.